Never been to the Shrine of the Most Blessed Sacrament?
Not a problem, because today we're taking you with us.
Hi, I'm Jennifer and this is Kate, and last month we had the opportunity to visit the Shrine of the Most Blessed Sacrament in Hanceville, Alabama, Mother Angelica's old stomping grounds.
The shrine is an amazingly beautiful place, and we were just blown away when we pulled up and realized that this is definitely holy ground.
We had no idea. I don't know what we were expecting, but it is huge, it is holy, it is just incredible.
And today we're going to be taking you on a tour with us so you can kind of feel like you're there. And we're also going to be doing a giveaway. So let's get started.
So we decided to come to the shrine on our way home from the feeding of the 5,000 in Texas for the Chosen. We had always wanted to come and visit, and now on the way home, it was the perfect time. So as you can probably tell, it is kind of out in the middle of nowhere. We were driving a lot of back roads to get there. And this is the very long drive that goes up to the front gate. So here is the front gate. And here's what it's like driving in. The very first thing we did when we got there was go in because we were able to actually catch a noon mass. So that was amazing. So this is what the church looks like from the courtyard, and the daily mass was held in the lower church, which was very beautiful. And here are some of the statues and pictures we saw inside.
We love this carousel of free rosaries and the Shroud of Turin replica. No photographs are allowed of the inside of the church sanctuary, but you can see the view from the steps. There are two beautiful colonnades. One has the Stations of the Cross, and one has the Divine Child Jesus. Wheelchairs are available for anyone in need, and there are beautiful garden spots like this where you can sit and meditate on the Beatitudes, or you can also think about the Ten Commandments. We love this beautiful statue of the Blessed Mother as well. Next, we visited the 12 Stations of the Most Holy Eucharist, which is a beautiful garden with 12 stations that help you reflect on the way God has provided food for His people all through the centuries, including providing Jesus the bread of life born in the house of bread. And here's another beautiful statue of the Blessed Mother.
After that, we visited the Castle San Miguel, which had like the information desk and conference rooms. It had some of these really cool old Bible pages too, and these really beautiful statues. So it was a really fun place to look around. It also housed the gift shop, which as you can see is very full and very extensive. Also a lot of fun to look around. Of course, we had to stop by the book section in the gift shop. It wouldn't be one of our videos if it didn't have books. You know us. This is the kids section right here. And then we went over to the more adult section. And we did end up buying some stuff in the gift shop, but we'll show you that at the end of the video.
It was hard to leave the gift shop, but then we took a short walk along this beautiful path, which goes right by a river, so we could hear the water flowing in the background, and it leads to this beautiful life-size replica of the Grotto at Lourdes. We are devoted to Our Lady of Lourdes here, so this was an amazing thing to discover on the grounds. We didn't know beforehand that it was here, but as you can see, we thoroughly enjoyed our time. We lit a votive candle. We visited with Saint Bernadette. We enjoyed Our Lady, the Immaculate Conception. And how cool is this? This rock actually came from the original Grotto in Lourdes. Then we're off to a building called the Creche.
Then we stopped by the life-size nativity set they had and lit some votive candles while we were there.
Our last stop and a highlight of the trip was the John Paul II Eucharistic Center. Inside there is a life-size monstrance. Those are benches that adult people can sit on, so it's big. Inside there are stations set up that walk you through the history of the Eucharist, starting with the first station, which is Passover. There are different videos. This one was John the Baptist talking about Jesus's ministry, how it started, the Last Supper, the institution of the Eucharist, so beautifully done. Here's Jesus preaching. And then there are different hallways set up with all kinds of displays that tell about the history of the Catholic Church, Eucharistic miracles, really anything you want to know about the Eucharist and why it's so very important. It's just such a neat place. We could really have spent hours in there. There are all different types of movies that you can watch. Here's a little booth with the history of John Paul II. A little hidey hole for the kids with neat things for them. And then the Eucharistic Martyrs Hall. That was really neat. These are life-size statues. You might recognize a few of these. Here is Nicholas Pick. And then coming up, we have one of our favorite saints, Blessed Imelda Lambertini. So it was like seeing old friends, and they are life-size statues, so it seems like they're really there with you. And at the very end of the tour, the Blessed Mother is there to tell you goodbye.
As you can see, it was such a beautiful place. We really had no idea before we went.
Yeah, we had never really looked into the shrine very much beforehand, aside from getting the directions. So it was a really, really nice surprise to drive up and see just how extensive the grounds were and all the things that were there.
Yeah, walking up to the main shrine, walking across that big courtyard, it felt like I'm in St. Peter's Square, except in Alabama.
But anyway, what did we get in the gift shop? Well, first off, we got some cookies there, these really amazing cookies. We ate them on the way home though, so they're not with us today.
We ate the evidence.
Yeah, but if you're there, do yourself a favor and try some of the cookies.
Yeah, they're near the register. I think there were 6 in a bag. Just buy them, they're so delicious. We actually wanted to buy everything in the store. It was such an incredible place, but we did manage to limit ourselves to just a few items. So let's show you what those are.
So to start off, they had all sorts of little freebies in there, like Our Lady of Life, Prayer for the Unborn, or this really cool one for St. Michael.
It has the prayer on the back, St. Michael prayer.
Yeah, and then we have this other little pamphlet, and we have the map. So just a couple of fun little things.
That was nice. It was all free. They just put it right in our gift bag. The gift shop just seemed to go on forever, and it was full of any Catholic item you could want. And one thing that I really like is Catholic stickers. So I found this set from Our Lady of Grace with the Miraculous Medal, which I'm all about the Miraculous Medal. So I definitely bought a set to take home.
And we also got this really pretty stained glass sun catcher of the Blessed Mother. Just caught our eye, $2.50. We bought it.
I was also happy to see that they had for sale this little booklet, Stations of the Holy Eucharist, which is a prayer book that takes you through all the ways Jesus feeds us, from manna in the desert to the Holy Eucharist itself. The wedding feast at Cana, the Nativity, Elijah and the hearth cakes. Really such a cool devotional that actually began in Hansville with Mother Angelica. So this is only $4. I thought I definitely need this.
And then we also picked up this book on St. John Paul the Great. And we actually got 2 copies. So we're going to be giving one of them away. So if you'd like to be entered in the giveaway, leave us a comment down below.
We have not read this one. It gets great reviews on Amazon though. So if you win our copy, we can read it together and compare notes. So there you have it, Mother Angelica, the Shrine of the Most Blessed Sacrament, and John Paul the Great.
So thank you so much for coming on the tour with us today. We hope that you enjoyed it. Again, leave us a comment if you want to be entered in the giveaway, and we will see you next time. Bye.